Hello and welcome to another video of the series Friends. In this video, we'll learn about how to deal with arrays in 8086. So first we'll see how to declare an array. As we have already seen how to declare a data type, a variable with data type and value. Here also we have the similar kind of steps. We have two examples. A is our array and B is our another array. Learn number system and conversion of binary number into hexadecimal and decimal number. That would help you a lot in this course. How to access a value from an array. Here you can see how we are accessing value from an array. So it is exactly similar as we have in higher level languages. We have an array A, allocated data byte of memory and with value 22H, 23H, 24H. So for each value, a byte of memory will be allocated. And using this A of 0 or A of 1, you can access the particular value at particular index. For example, we can see here, if you want to store any value from an array A to the AL register, we can simply use this operation, move AL, A of 2. Or also we can use index registers, that is SI and DI. So first we are moving 2 into SI, and again we are doing the operation move AL into A of SI, that is, that will be similar to the previous operation, move AL into A of 2. If you didn't understand this example, there is no need to worry. In the upcoming section, you will be understanding this example. Here we have a instruction DUP that stands for duplicate. That will help you in declaring an array. So through the example you can understand, we are declaring an array X with memory data byte, defined byte, and you can see here that the 7 is duplicated 3 times. So this is the format of using DUP. The number which you assign before DUP instruction, that many times the number which you pass inside the DUP is copied. Like we have copied 7 to 3 times. In another example, we have an array Y, which is exactly similar to an array X, but instead of value 7, 7, 7, we have value 5, 6. So the 5, 6 are repeated to 3 times. That is, we have 3, 5, 6, 5, 6, 5, 6. I would like to repeat it again. The number which you assign before DUP instruction, that is the number, the another number is copied. Like 7 is getting copied to 3 times. What if in certain condition we need to declare an empty array? Like in C, we have an array where, and we are allocating 10 spaces for that, initializing each value with 0. We can do the similar operation in 8086 assembly language using DUP operator. This question mark tells the compiler to create duplicate number of spaces and each initialized with 0. So we can later replace those value with different number. We have used here DUP, as I have already discussed that DUP copy the number which is passed inside up to the number of times which is assigned before DUP. So the question mark will be copied.